I sell very few pieces through gallery systems anymore. A lot of it's online. We sell higher end, like sofas. Anyone ever, you know what sofa is in Chicago? Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's, we've got a couple of galleries that take our work there. And, you know, it's different. Everything's just different. I always complain that you should be able to, you know, the fame that comes later, any kind of attention that comes later, just because you've been around so long, you're irritated. A lot of people may remember your name. I'm doing this in case I have way too much air in it. It'd be so nice to get around that clay that Zach wedged for me. You see the different form that this takes. It's almost like a flying saucer. You've got to get rid of that skirt that hangs on the outside. You never get a nice bottom on anything.
You only pull up once.
Sometimes.
And back down, is that just based on the clay? The
yeah, well, it's based on the amount of air I put in this. Okay. You shouldn't have it. But I've done a horrible, very bad job.
No, I mean, you're not like three times.
No, no, no. Well, the Japanese do that. They'll do it five or six times. Sometimes. And it just makes the clay dense and easier to throw. You're wedging it when you do that. Did you know that? It's not anything else. This is another bowl that I usually, this form I do in the wood fire or soda. Anyone ever fired in a big wood fire, Kim?
No? Want to.
A lot of work. It's like 2 weeks. And sometimes the stuff's uglier when it comes out than when you put it in.
Does Amy go to fire her still?
I don't know. That's not just been. We're trying to get, you know, either Frank Boyden or Al Tennant to help fire because they don't know. Everyone used to build these, including me, these big, huge kilns. You know, that was the big deal in the 80s. Make a 2,000 cubic foot kiln. All right, so now the bottom piece is what I'm going to trim, so I'm not going to just get that very thin at all. You know, this will be the thicker, this will support anything. This is not a big bowl. This is about 2 pounds, a little over maybe, not even that. But you can mess with this bottom and it will slump on you real fast. The more slip you have in the water, the better it is. There's things you can add to your throwing water to throw any kind of clay along for a longer period of time without adding the water. One is wallpaper paste, a cellulose that you can add as a powder. You have to change that water every day because it smells like a sewer at the end of the day. Not a good smell. Leach, when I knew David Leach, he always added sugar, a tablespoon of sugar to his throwing water, which improved the throwing. It made your hands just slide over the outside surface and not catch. When you're throwing with your fingernail, you know, it can catch really easily.
So it fills up your fingerprints?
But
sugar fills in your fingerprints?
No.
No.
It makes it slide.
So. You know, if I have nothing against throw marks. People say, well, why do you always erase? I have nothing against that. If you use a throw mark for decoration, but if you're trying to decorate a surface with a bunch of throw marks on it, it just doesn't work. You want that purity of the clay. And also, Frank Boyden figured out that the more you seal that outside clay, the more the glaze is going to be beautiful. It's going to take wood fire, and he really studied wood fire because wood fire, and so does atmosphere, turns into a gas, and whatever gas settles on the surface creates the color. The smoother the surface, more like screening concrete, sealing, you know, smoothing the concrete off, the more luscious the color is going to be. If it's all rough and rugged, it's just going to soak into it like a piece of sponge. These ribs are very beneficial to me. I have to have them, but they're real dangerous. This is as sharp as a razor. I mean, if you did this, you just cut yourself wide open. And was it you, Zach, was saying you were deathly afraid of cutting your hand off at him?
Yeah.
That would be the end of your career, right there. Then you could take your finger like this. And throw with it.
Knuckle pull.
Yeah, that's the way I was taught, to pull with your knuckle. Anyone else?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you use credit cards as ribs?
No.
You can cut them in different shapes.
Yeah.
They're flexible, they don't cut you.
You see what causes problem though, Mary, is a squared off edge. If you look